guys, it's time for Mini System Test 55. And in this video, I have a very special guest. And that person is...
Hi, Mr. Truealert.
It's Mr. Truealert, that's right. He's joining me for this video. So, let's get started. I have my Firelight BG10LX, my SD355, and the Wheelock NS. The Wheelock NS is doing code 3. This had a problem with it where I would pull it and the button was still stuck inside. These do not, as much as I like them, they're not reliable. So, here's the inside of the 9200, still the same, no batteries. And, yeah. So, if you have epilepsy, don't watch this. You ready?
Absolutely, fire
away. Alright, here we go. Oh, here we, told you. Hopefully the neighbors don't come knocking on my door.
They would be knocking on the door at my house, Dave. It would be ridiculous.
Oh, God. Has that happened?
I'd have the police show up.
Oh, my God. Wow.
But they're like, okay, we're glad that you have a protective system. Just make sure in the future to let us know.
Yeah, seriously. All right, that's reset. I don't have a magnet, so... To substitute, we'll do the drill button. And notice how when the system is in alarm and I hold the drill button, the alarm silence LED is still illuminated even when the horns are going. On the UDLS, if you hold down the drill button while the system's in alarm, the alarm silence LED will turn off, which is kind of odd.
I believe that that's firmware, Dave.
Yeah, you know what? Yeah, I think you're right. And we'll acknowledge the trouble. So that was Mini System Test 55. Hope you guys enjoyed it. And Mr. Truealert, do you want to say anything before I end the video?
Sure, yes. When I get going here with the next test, you guys will be absolutely shocked at what I was able to scavenge. So I hope to see you guys soon, and it's always a pleasure watching your videos, and I hope you enjoy mine as well. But just stay tuned, because something very rare I've acquired is coming your way.
Oh, yeah. You guys have a lot to look forward to.
Oh, yeah, and then not only that, too, if you guys ever get a 4100U, let's just say prepare for during the rain to have ground faults drive you nuts.
Oh, God. Are you kidding me?
The reason being is because of the fact that with the 4100U and your SPS system power supply, you end up having some sort of component that's extra sensitive to getting ground faults. And when you have your ground connected to the house, what will happen is that when there's water around the lightning rod, you'll get a trouble. The trouble will go in and out like crazy.
That'll do
it. Word of advice, there's a way to latch that trouble so that you can just go ahead and just let it be in trouble until the system clears.
Yeah, I was going to ask you whether or not you had that latched.
Yeah, it's always.
All right, guys. Well, thanks for watching, and we'll talk to you soon.